Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for November 26th of 2021, well, it is titled Great Refractor and Lunar Eclipse. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image taken from inside the dome of one of the largest refracting telescopes, and that is the 36-inch Lick Observatory refractor. And located in California, this is one of the large refracting telescopes built in the late 1800s, which was an era when many of these were built, ranging up to about a 40-inch telescope currently at Yerkes Observatory. So we have some very large refracting telescopes that were built this time. And here we see this one pointing out towards the lunar eclipse that was seen just about a week ago. And as we look out, we see the eclipsed moon, or partially eclipsed moon, with the eclipsed portion on the right hand side and the uneclipsed portion a little overexposed on the left. And then up above it, we see the Pleiades star cluster. And that is an open cluster of stars that happen to be in the general direction of the moon and Earth's shadow on the day of the eclipse. Now, as I said, this was a large refractor and one of the largest, but was built in the late 1800s. And in fact, very few large refracting telescopes have been built since then. And there are a few reasons for that. First of all, the big chunk of glass that makes up the lens of a refracting telescope is very difficult to make and to make large. While we have many times larger mirrors, a mirror has to be ground to a smooth, perfect surface on one side, and the glass itself can be somewhat impure because the light does not pass through it. Now, in the case of a refracting telescope, which uses the lens to focus the light actually has to pass through the lens. And that means that both sides of the lens have to be ground to the right configuration, and the glass inside has to be pure. So trying to build something that is, in this case, nearly a meter across is very difficult. And you can imagine trying to build something as large as the Hubble Space Telescope, which is nearly 2.5 meters across, or some of the other larger telescopes that we use now that are 8 and 10 and 12 meters across, that it is would be very difficult to get a lens that would work the way we can work with mirrors. So for that reason, mirrors have taken over the last century and become the dominant type of astronomical telescope. But a few of these older refractors still exist. And here we see one of them looking out towards the lunar eclipse of November the 19th. So that was our picture of the day for November 26th of 2021. It was titled Great Refractor and Lunar Eclipse. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.